Today's talk is a close look at the costs that Mercedes is experiencing with their Class 7 50,000 pound freight truck versus the costs being incurred by Tesla with their 80,000 pound truck. And I think you'll find the results kind of interesting. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Bonjour, wie geht's? Guten Tag, ni hao ma. I was intrigued because one thing that had come up was the whole, how can you look at costs and how are customers going to react to those costs? Bob Lutz made a comment where he said, look, the problem with Tesla is that if it costs $100,000 for a sort of middle-range Model S Tesla, how in the world are they going to be able to sell trucks that typically cost between $100,000 and $130,000 to customers around the world? So likely we're talking a $200,000-$300,000 truck, which wouldn't be cost-effective for most of the businesses that have to use it. So I thought that was an interesting comment that he made. So I decided to maybe do a breakdown of what the numbers are like. Let's start with Mercedes, Daimler-Benz, and their Class 7 trucks. So Mercedes has decided to come out with a class with delivery vans that go 150 miles. They've come out with a Class 6 truck under the Fuso brand that goes between 100 and 120 miles. And they're leasing that vehicle for $600 a month. And then now they've come out with a Class 7 truck, which is capable of 50,000 pounds of freight. And they're saying the range on it is someplace in the 200-ish plus or minus 20-mile zone. What was interesting about this vehicle is that it's using an 18650 battery. And according to J.B. Stroebel, those battery packs are running Tesla still about $30,000 in order to build an 18650 battery that's 100 kW. So Mercedes is definitely using three of these packs, but possibly four. And let's say that the cost per unit is about $30,000 per pack times four. We're talking 120K, and this is just in batteries. Again, from J.B. Stroebel, there are four, let's say, Model S engines in there. So let's say that's another 20-ish, maybe 30K. So now we're up to about $150,000 for that vehicle. And then now we have to do the rest of the truck, and that's the, you know, the rear of the truck and, you know, the front and electronics and all that. So one could argue that's another minimum 20 grand, possibly $30,000. So out the door, what we're facing with the Mercedes Class 7 truck is about a $200,000 bill for a vehicle that goes about 200 miles and totes about 50,000 pounds of vehicle and weight. And so the question is, what's the deal on this and how do customers react and does it make any sense? And the answer is, they've been testing these vehicles in Stuttgart, Germany successfully, and they're now rolling them out with customers around the world starting to buy them at those higher prices. One of the answers to those high costs is to actually go for a leasing model instead of selling them. That way you can, in theory, most companies tend not, you know, tend to lease, not buy, and I guess you could add up benefits that are associated with that. What's fascinating to me about how those numbers are working is that when you reduce operating costs, be it fuel as well as repair costs, by let's say 70%, the 200K, which is almost double what you have to pay for a comparable diesel truck, doesn't look as bad. Plus, you can meet government mandates regarding pollution, etc. So bottom line is that if you go through what the numbers look like, that 3 times better efficiency from coming from electricity versus using diesel to power the truck eliminates pollution, reduces cost enough so that even though you're facing a big bill to pay for the initial vehicle, customers are signing up. In the case of the Class 7 Mercedes under the Fuso brand, they're just rolling it out right now, so we don't know what orders are like based on the prices we just described. But it was kind of interesting because in the case of the Class 6 truck under the Fuso brand, the large customers who are allowed to try them out have all been like, we'll take as many as you can make. And so this despite the fact that they're using definitely 2, but possibly as many as 3 100 kW battery packs from a Model S inside of those trucks. So even in the Class 6 version, people are facing a 100K bill for battery packs, and then they build trucks up from there. So let's say it's $125,000 versus them paying 60 to 80K for that vehicle originally. And again, Mercedes has chosen to go for a $600 a month lease as these are being rolled out, but initially only to big customers. I want to give a shout out quickly to my friends who are constantly on my case about, you know, where do you get your info from, et cetera, et cetera. And note that, you know, Mercedes is gone for the $600 lease price, which really eliminates the whole discussion of what it costs to buy, because that's not transparent. The shout out to my angry customers goes to the fact that Mercedes is saying delivery times for orders that they've received is someplace in the middle of next year, even though they've been working on the truck for 10 years. And the issue is that they're building new plants to handle the production for these vehicles. And what's happening is Mercedes is transitioning over from using Tesla batteries into using their own first drivetrains, then batteries as they can. And it's my sense that based on them not putting all the product on the street that the customers want right now, that they actually are still buying batteries to provide solutions to customers and don't have the ability to produce at scale yet these solutions so that anybody wanting one can just walk into the store and purchase it. You do have to give Daimler-Benz credit, though, because versus where Tesla's at and sort of still the test phase and even Cummins, they deserve a lot of credit because they've been testing it aggressively in different settings, and they're now taking orders and have it in customer hands and being used and in a visible way, which is very different than everybody else. So they've just gotten to market earlier than anyone, and they deserve credit for that. I wanted to then now, so let's say we build up a Class 7 truck, 50,000 pounds of carrying, on a Mercedes platform, which is an 18650 battery. That number's a 200K purchase price. And then all the other benefits you get bring that price in the line with what people are dealing with, and therefore you can sell them because customers can get the benefits. And particularly if you're leasing, you don't actually out the box face the larger purchase price that it's prohibitive for many people given how much higher the output is on the front end. If we switch over to Tesla, as we've discussed in previous videos, J.B. Strobel is suggesting that we're using 4 battery packs from the largest battery pack from the Model 3, plus 4 of the drivetrains for the Model 3 to power their trucks. So if in fact those numbers are correct, let's for giggles say it's 5 of them. The largest Model 3 engine is going for $8,600. So this vehicle then, let's say for giggles, we have 5 Model 3 engines at $10,000 a piece, which is 50K, plus 4 Model 3 engines at about, let's say $3,000 a piece. So what we're ending up is around $60,000 before we put a cab and all the other stuff on our Tesla Semi. So let's say theoretically we can put the outside shell on for another $10,000. again, we're in that $60,000 to $70,000 range for worst case scenario on what the Model 3 based semi looks like. What this results in is customers by default are looking at, they can spend $200,000 for a 50,000-pound Mercedes truck, or they can spend, you know, Tesla can come in anywhere from 130 to 150K for their product, and in essence, it's over double what their costs are. So, and I built those costs out, as you've seen, from sort of a worst-case scenario. So basically, what we're talking about is, you know, Tesla has a 50% advantage with a 2170 battery over competing firms that are trying to mirror them currently, and they have such a wide advantage that when you add in the 70% reduction in costs related to trucking in this space, you know, Tesla could walk in and say Mercedes wants $200,000 for their truck, in essence, and we'll offer you a truck that carries 30,000 pounds more and has double the range or 50% more range, let's say between 300 and 400 miles, but we'll give it to you for 150K. So Tesla could play all kinds of games on pricing. You know, if, I mean, the mind-blowing consideration is if Tesla said, we'll give you our truck at the same price that Mercedes is giving you their truck, except for we give you double the miles and 30,000 pounds more weight, but the price is the same. So can you imagine if Tesla actually said, how about you pay us if the equivalent of $200,000 per truck, and we give you way better performance than what Mercedes is offering on a number of metrics. And in the meantime, the profit margin is the distance between about $65,000 and $200,000, or per truck profits up in the $130,000 per zone, which is, wow, that's pretty mind-blowing to be able to get that kind of margin and also have your customers getting solutions that provide a great value. So I think this is a fascinating, you know, sort of play around with numbers situation, and hopefully Tesla is putting those battery packs sitting around, not completed because the Model 3 is slow, into some of the other channels like trucks, because I think they could make a killing there, which would help feed the rest of the country company. Look forward to your comments on this. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Tschüss, mach's gut, au revoir, la hit road. Please like and subscribe, and look and any questions or input you might have, always appreciated.